With the latest release of Adobe XD, it's much easier to view and override trigger options now that you have access to the Properties Inspector in both design and prototype mode. I'm here in Adobe XD, and I've got a nice flow that I've been working on. I'm in design mode. I can see that in the upper left-hand corner, and on the right-hand side, I have the Properties Inspector. When I switch over in this latest version of XD to prototype mode, notice that I still have the Properties Inspector there on the right-hand side, but in it, I have options that are focused on how to define various interactions. If I come in and select all on the canvas, so pull down under Edit to select all, you can see I've got a lot going on here. Over the last few releases of Adobe XD, the team has really stepped up all of the ways that you can interact with prototypes, adding to triggers like tap, drag, and voice, things like keyboard commands and gamepad controllers. You also have the ability to drag a wire from artboard to artboard or from individual object within an artboard to another artboard. With access to the Properties Inspector here in the prototype mode, I can come in and access the content in different ways. As you look down here, you can see I've got a few wires that are defined. Let's kind of just dig in here a little bit more. There's one little hidden gem with XD20 that I want to mention real quickly, and that's the fact that you can now scroll on the design canvas as you drag elements or wires. Let me show you what I mean. I'll click off real quickly here and just click on this first artboard. Let's say I wanted to drag a wire for another artboard from this one, but it's off screen here towards the right. When I now approach the edge of the screen, notice that it scrolls for me. No longer do I need to zoom out and zoom back in just to try to orient myself in relationship to content or artboards that are off screen. So this applies to both wires and objects that I might be dragging, let's say, from one artboard to another. Okay, now that I have that set, let's go back to where we were. I'm going to go ahead and select all once again. I've got one wire that's coming from an artboard at the upper level. I've got a wire that's been defined from this object to transition to the second artboard. I've got another one that's selecting this object to transition to the next artboard. If I want to, I can come in and just click on that one object, and with it selected, see all of the properties there on the right-hand side. Let's say I want to make sure that the transition that I've defined from this first object to this artboard is the same as the transition from this object and the next artboard. What I can do is come in and select that first object, and then hold down Shift and select the second object. With both of them selected, I can now see everything that's common and everything that's different in the Properties Inspector. So they're both set to tap with a transition. Notice that Preserve Scroll Position has been moved over here from the Properties Inspector on the design mode side, because it really has to do with flows and prototyping. Under destination, it's a mixed state because the destination is different from one artboard to another, so that makes sense. I can see the mixed state indicator with this long dashed line. The animation is dissolved. What I want to do is set the same easing and same duration so I have a little more consistency. I can come to that mixed state indicator here and just go on in and have them both ease in as they transition. And then under duration, I'll set the time to be the same at 0.6 seconds. Another really powerful feature, believe it or not, is the ability to turn off wires if you decide you no longer want them. In some situations, you may want to take a set of artboards and duplicate them and define an entirely different flow. And undoing wires, trying to select them and drag them back, can be really time consuming. If I go ahead and step back a bit so we can see all of the artboards in this flow, and then press and drag to select the artboard level. Notice that the name of the artboard is highlighted in blue. That lets me know I'm at that artboard selection level. From here, I can come in and leave these common attributes, trigger and transition. What I want to do is under destination, scroll all the way up towards the top and select none. That, in essence, disables that wire. I can do that same thing at an individual object level. Let's say I select all on the canvas. Notice this doesn't select artboards, it selects all of the objects on the canvas. And I can tell that because the artboards are gray, they're not blue, they're not selected. And there's all of the wires for all of the flow that I have selected. Once again, I'll come in and leave it as tap and transition. And under destination, I'm going to go in and set none as an option. This is definitely a workflow that you need to start to familiarize yourself with, but I think you'll see it's a really nice productivity enhancement. I encourage you to give it a try.